Okay, cue the music. Jonathan Fibonacci, nature lover, dad, stock trader, teacher, book reader, cannabis advocate, says right here, photographer, newbie, comic. Cue the music. Man, my intro. Still working on it, Jonathan Fibonacci, PCH, holla. A little falsetto, maybe a little more holla. Maybe, okay, how about this? Jonathan Fibonacci, PCH, boom, Durango. Okay, now how about we just start over? Okay, we're going to start with some music. Gonna talk about money, documentaries. Can I do it? Can I cover all the ground? Bitch, I could. I survive. Here we go. Money. Luga dana dominose. Danada terra carasini. Asparagus apprehendi salientio. Masi and Sabravini Vivi. Okay, I'm not professional yet. Okay, here we go. Picture time. Maybe talk about some documentaries. All right. Man, I love her voice. Holy shit. Etsu buenos. Ese, whoever posted this song is really cool. Thank you. Okay, there's my intro. Ese, ese vivino. Just walk up to someone and go, "Eu estu vivio Fibonacci hala nigga." Don't be saying none of that stuff. I like fire. Okay. Intro is over. I don't know if you've heard. I'm kind of a big deal now. Look at this. Picture time. There you go. Look at that. That's how my day started. Okay, let me tell you how my day started. There's Durango. Beautiful. Durango has the best library in the world. In fact, Durango has everything. Everything Durango does is better than your city, basically, is what I'm trying to say. I'm using their library, and you can notice there's a river in the background. Beautiful quote. You have to see the mountain from every side. Beautiful. There's a quote of the day. Okay, we're going to talk about the Fibonacci tree sequence. Gonna end up like this. I'm gonna talk about Jesus first. Beautiful. Right there, boom. See it? I know. And then we end up here. The Fibonacci tree sequence. You know, in fact, maybe I should use the Fibonacci tree sequence to teach people how to day trade. See, and how photography has so many applications to trading, the stock market. You're like, Fibonacci, can you just go back to being LOL funny, not make me think? I can't, dude. See this beautiful tree. Came this beautiful tree and how I approach photography and how it's probably influenced by trading. Phase one, phase two, three, and four, and five. And you're like, is that Durango? Because that's awesome. But we only got there. There you go. Okay, so there's my, that was my walk. Let me show you how my day started. Started with this. Look at this. Boom. Well, that was actually a gift. I haven't used it yet. It's from Pakistan. That's a story in itself. You know, there are two types of giving. Here you go. Pakistani Kush. Here's the story to that. Who's that beautiful guy in the background? Holla. You're like, that's what you should do, Fibonacci. You should do some cannabis advocacy, and you should be talking about different types of cannabis and medicinal therapies, and then you could show your photography and Hogwarts, and then you could talk about aliens that you see on your walk at Durango, and you could just make this channel all about the hobbits and the Hogwarts that you see when you're on. And then you're like, okay, is he J.K. Rowling? What the fuck is he going? Where is this guy? I thought he said he was in Durango. But here he is, J.K. Lan. No, not J.K. Right here. This is where it's all going to end up. Basically AI. I can't go into the book of Revelations too much on YouTube. But it's all going to go down to AI. I think J.K.'s book was really just a protocol. You want to make sure you give your children lots of, let's talk about candy. Let's talk about candy. This is just my walk. There's a beautiful, about 100 yards from here, there's this beautiful independent bookstore, which those are some of the best words in the world, and they have all kinds of cool things, and in fact, a lot of really good Indian, Hopi Indian, Native American. I mean, this is just it's probably the best bookstore in the world, and I saw this in their window today, and then including this guy. Boom. And so how do we go from starting your day with some Kush, and where do we go from here? So let me tell you the story behind this Pakistani Chitral Kush. You know, like I said earlier, there's two types of giving. There's giving out of prosperity, and there's giving out of poverty. And where I'm staying in Durango, this beautiful motel, beautiful, it's called the Caboose Motel. There's this beautiful, it's just the best place in the world. And they have this woman, this girl that cleans the properties after people leave. Except this guy doesn't leave. I just keep re-upping month after month after month. And you know, she knows I smoke herb. She knows I like herb, because obviously the no smoking room probably smells a lot like Fibonacci challah. So, and just trust me when I say, you can tell that resources are not abundant with her. And she probably isn't on an hourly wage like a lot of people work in these beautiful Colorado towns. And she'll give me, she'll bring me towels in the morning, and she'll give me cannabis and different types of cannabis. And today's, you know, she picked up, and I asked her, I said, how much are these? You need to stop being so nice to me. I said, how much are these? And she said, $10. And I think about an hourly wage person giving that out of poverty. And so I thought, you know, that's, it's like Mark Twain says, there's nothing worse than a good example. And I, you know, her name, I'll keep it anonymous, but she's just a beautiful heart, and I'll give her a big hug and just tell her, you know, but I could tell when she's given it to me, she's given that out of her poverty. She's given that to be kind. She's given that out of love. And whenever, not only do I enjoy cannabis, but you know, I'll even pick a picture of it and put it on my YouTube channel and go, now this is what giving out of poverty looks like. And it makes me think of those days when, you know, I ran a $200,000 a year finance company. And if you think in terms of percentages, how many gifts did I give to people that were that abundant? How many times did I show up on somebody's door giving them $1,000? Because back then, $1,000 was nothing. And for this girl, $10 is equivalent to a whole day's, or probably, it's the hourly wage is what, you know, so she's working and, you know, and she's doing it to be kind. So here you go, Fibonacci style. I've decided I'm going to bless her back, and I'm going to kind of go, Jesus. So, boom. So I thought, well, how do I do it? Let me do it this way. What if I did this, and I kind of opened my Jesus Bible, and you know, I know the Bible says you're not supposed to advertise your giving, and the Bible even says if you do that, then you have your reward. And so I thought, you know what, I'm going to give back to this. And I went to the grocery store, and I got $50. And so next time I see her, next time she gives me towels, she's going to get four things. It says, love one another with brotherly affection or sisterly affection. And that's what Jesus looks like. Not Fibonacci challah, but just in your own way, blessing people and having lost that finance company and having gone through a lot of heartache, it's amazing how heartache makes you sensitive to even the littlest kindness in people. And so, in fact, when they gave me that, they originally gave me 20s, and I said, no, I want her to have a $50 bill, because there's something about giving somebody $50. So here you go, Fibonacci Challenge, wherever you're at. There's somebody in your life that needs 50 bucks, a couple Snickers, maybe a cigarette lighter, maybe a cannabis lighter. Maybe it's just, maybe for you, $5 is it. Maybe for you, it's a dollar. Find someone in your community that needs that. And bless the fuck out of them today. You know, maybe take a picture of the black and white Fibonacci. See the authentic, and don't do it for promotion. In fact, just maybe take a picture of your gift and give them the dignity of privacy. But bless somebody today, and I hope this channel is bringing you light and love. Bringing you light and love. So there you go. Cue the music. Getting all sappy. But you know, I said earlier that a lot of times when you go through heartbreak, it makes you more sensitive to the kindnesses and the need for kindness. And there's a quote there somewhere. It's on the internet everywhere, but I can't think of exactly who said it, but it says, wherever you're at, there's somebody with a burden that you don't know anything about. And so to be kind. So I close out. Americano417@gmail.com. I was born in a thunderstorm. I grew up overnight. I played alone, I played on my own. I survived. Hey. You guys be good.